But we're going to share some things today that help us to see that that's not the case. Our loving Creator, Almighty God, did not intend for us to just live a short period of time and then just die. What kind of God would that be, if you think about that? Would that be a loving God to create us, to have us be born, to live 70, 80 years, grow old, get sick, and then we die? That wasn't God's purpose, and really, that's not His will. And so we're going to talk about that a little bit. And it's natural. It's natural for loved ones to grieve over the death of someone they hold dear. So because we grieve, really, it's a sign of being made in God's image. You see, Jehovah did not intend for anyone to die. That wasn't His purpose. He did not intend for that to happen. And so it's a natural reaction to grief. For those of us who read the Bible and know the Bible well, we understand that because when Jesus was on the earth, God's Son, and His good friend Lazarus died, you know what Jesus did? The Bible says that He wept. Jesus gave way to tears. The Son of God, He felt the emotion, the pain of losing His good friend Lazarus in death. And so Jesus cried. So there's nothing wrong with crying a little bit. If you're a man, it's okay to cry. If you're a woman, it's okay to cry. If you're a child, it's okay to cry. It's okay to grieve. It's okay. And Jehovah understands that. But the Bible really gives hope. It gives hope for those who fall asleep in death. Jehovah is a God of wisdom, justice, love, and power. Death, as we mentioned, was not a part of God's original purpose. Well, why do we grow old? And why do people die? Well, it was because of the sin of our first forefather, who was Adam. Adam was given a commission by God to live, take care of the earth, and to be obedient, and to live forever. Adam and Eve, his wife, were to live forever in a paradise earth. But something went wrong. What went wrong was Adam disobeyed God. And when he did that, really, he lost his precious relationship with God. That being the case then, Adam lost the prospect to live forever. Only if he had remained obedient, then perfect humans would be on this earth today. Adam was created perfect. Eve was created perfect. All they had to do was be obedient to God, and they would live forever. But because that wasn't the case, Adam and Eve disobeyed God. That brought to the human family sin. Adam and Eve sinned against God. So Adam and Eve, being the parents of all humans, every human came from Adam and Eve. No matter what color you are, no matter what social status you may be, every single human came from Adam and Eve. And because Adam and Eve sinned, we inherited that sin from Adam and Eve. Now think about it this way. If you were to have a pan that you cooked a cake in, and you cooked this cake in this pan all the time, and this pan had a dent in it. Every time you would cook a cake, no matter how many times you cook that cake, you know what's going to happen? When you cook that cake would always have a dent in it. No matter what you did, that cake would always have a dead end. Why? Because the pen has a dead end. So it's the same way with Adam. Because Adam sinned, and he being our, and Eve being the parents of all living humans, then we inherited that sin from Adam and Eve. And that's why we grow old and die. Because that's what happened to Adam and Eve, because they were disobedient to God. So the Bible then tells us really why we are in the position that we're in. And so we understand that God understands that as well, but really, how does God feel about those who grieve and go through what we are facing even right today, even right now? Well, in the book of Psalm, chapter 34, and verse number 18, notice what it says about God, whose name is Jehovah. It says, he is close to the brokenhearted. He saves those who are crushed in spirit. Now that's comforting to know that God is close to all that are brokenhearted. So let me ask you, how does your heart feel right now? Is it broken? Do you feel pain because of what's happened to our beloved mama here? Does that cause you pain? Of course it does. But again, it says in this verse that Jehovah is close to those who are brokenhearted. He saves those who are crushed in spirit. So God cares. He really cares. He cares. And so that being said, you may wonder then, well, what will God do about it? Why does God allow for these types of things to happen? Well, it's because of an issue that was raised by none other than the ruler of this world. Now some may think, well, isn't God the ruler of this world? Well, think about it for a moment. If Almighty God, who we describe as a God of justice, love, wisdom, and power, if he were ruling this world in which we live right now, do you think the world would be in the shape that it's in right now? Do you think a God of love would allow, would cause someone to suffer, would cause this coronavirus that everybody's dealing with? Do you think God is the cause of this? Of course not. The Bible clearly describes that the ruler of this world is none other than Satan, the devil. Now to some, they may be a fictional character. It may be in our minds what we've seen maybe portrayed as someone with two horns, a long tail, and a pitchfork in a red suit. But make no mistake about it, according to God's word of the Bible, Satan the devil is a real spiritual being. And he is causing the havoc that we see on the earth today. As a matter of fact, he was the one that tempted Adam and Eve to sin against God. Satan was the one who did that. And so you see, Satan is the cause of it all. Satan is the one that is governing this world that we live in. Now, he did not create the earth, but because of his rebellious spirit, and because he was wanting something that didn't belong to him, like worship that belonged to God, and so therefore he tempted Adam and Eve, then Satan was kicked out of the heavens to the vicinity of the earth. And that's why we see the bad things that we see on the earth today. It's because of Satan the devil. Now, there are scriptures to back up all of the information that I'm giving you today, but due to time, we don't have that to read all of these scriptures, but I will be happy to give them all to you if you wanted them. Our sister Olga could do that as well. But everything that I'm mentioning to you is outlining God's word, the Bible. So the Bible clearly tells us the condition of the dead. It tells us what the condition of the dead is. So we're going to really appreciate that. So we're going to go to Psalm again, the book of Psalm, and we're going to look at chapter 146, and I'm going to share with you verse 4. It's talking about those who have fallen asleep in death. It says, his spirit goes out, he returns to the ground, on that very day his thoughts perish. So really then, they are in a condition of unconsciousness. Unconsciousness. Another scripture that will help us to understand that as well is in the book of Ecclesiastes. So in the book of Ecclesiastes, I'm going to share with you Ecclesiastes chapter 9 in verse 5. Notice what it says about the condition of the dead. It says, for the living know that they will die, but the dead know nothing at all, nor do they have any more reward, because all memory of them is forgotten. So when someone is dead, according to the Bible, it says they are not conscious of anything, that they know nothing at all. And in the account where Jesus wept over his beloved friend Lazarus, when Jesus went to the tomb of Lazarus and resurrected him, Jesus mentioned that Lazarus was in a deep sleep. That's how Jesus viewed death, as a deep sleep. And so too, we can appreciate that the dead are really conscious of nothing. They're not suffering. They don't have any memory. There's nothing going on. They're just like they were in a deep sleep. In a deep sleep. It's just like if you were, like when you go to sleep, do you remember the exact date and time that you fell asleep? No one can do that. No one. When you go to sleep, you're asleep. And when you get up, you know exactly what time you wake up, so you look at the clock and you know that you've awakened. But you do not know when you go to sleep. You don't know the exact time. And so, really that tells us that when we are in a deep sleep, we're not conscious of anything. And that is true of those who fall asleep in death today. So when we think then of individuals who die to God, it's as if they're in a deep sleep. Well, what will God do for those who have fallen asleep in death? What is God's purpose? As we mentioned, some may think, well, we live a short time, we die, and then that's it. But according to God's word, the Bible, what really is the reality of it all? Well, the Bible gives a hope to millions who have died, that they will live again. In the book of John, chapter 5, let me share with you what Jesus said about the dead. John, chapter 5, and I'm going to read with you verse 28 and 29. And these are the words of Jesus in John, chapter 5, 28 and 29. Jesus said, do not be amazed at this, for the hour is coming in which all those in the memorial tombs or the grave will hear his voice and come out, those who did good things to a resurrection of life, and those who practiced vile things to a resurrection of judgment. The verse says that those in the memorial tombs will hear his voice and come out. So yes, that's the promise of a resurrection. Of a resurrection of those who have fallen asleep in death. Well, how do we know that's a guarantee? Well, let's look at another verse in John chapter 5. This time we're going to look at verse 25. It says, most truly I say to you, the hour is coming, and it is now, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who have paid attention will live. Wow. Those who love God will live. What a comforting thought that is. Yes, those who love God will live. Also, another comforting scripture is in the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 21. Let me share this verse with you. Notice God's promise. In Revelation chapter 21, in verse 4, it says, and he, talking about God, will wipe out every tear from their eyes, and death will be no more, neither mourning, nor outcry, nor pain be anymore, for the former things have passed away. Isn't that a beautiful thought? That there will come a time that death will be no more. There will be no more pain. There will be no more suffering. The Bible says that the former things have passed away. Of course, we know there's a future time. Because right now, we still grow old. We get sick and we die. But the Bible holds out that hope for a future time. And so it's important that we recognize, and when we study God's Word, the Bible, we see all these amazing promises, all these beautiful promises that he has in store for mankind. Again, if we take the time to look into God's Word, to study God's Word, the Bible, we can come to appreciate all these beautiful, beautiful things that God will do in the future. Well, how can we benefit? How can you and I benefit just from being here today? Well, we can benefit from the simple fact that we all loved Mama, didn't we? We loved her. We loved her. But isn't it comforting to know that she has really the opportunity to be resurrected again? I mean, to live again. Now, the Bible says that when we die, really our sins are forgiven. In Romans chapter 5, verse 12. Yes, the wages sin pays is death. So when someone falls asleep in death, then their sins are gone. Therefore, God will give the opportunity to live again. So, all those who have fallen asleep in death are really asleep, as Lazarus was to Jesus, in God's memory. So God has the ability to resurrect all those who have fallen asleep in death. God has that type of power. He can do that. He can resurrect all those who have fallen asleep in death. And he will do the same for our beloved Mama here. Jehovah will do that for her. So by being here today, then, we need to think about, well, if God is going to give her a chance to live again, where will she live? Well, the Bible tells us in a paradise earth, in a place where Adam and Eve first were put, was a paradise. Adam and Eve had everything they needed. God placed them in a garden, the Garden of Eden, and they had everything they needed in order to live. They didn't get old, they didn't get sick, they had all the food, everything they needed. So God's original purpose is to bring those things back. That's what we described in Revelation chapter 21, verse 4. in that paradise earth that those who love God await that paradise earth. So if God then is going to resurrect those who have fallen asleep in death into that paradise, what should you and I be thinking about? Well, what do I need to do to be where she's going to be, right? That's where we want to be, because if she's going to be resurrected by God, if God is going to grant that to her, then wouldn't you and I want to be where she's going to be so we can welcome her back? We can be joined with her again? So that's important, because if that's the case for all of us, we want to make sure that we're living our lives in such a way that we show God that we want to be obedient to Him, that we too want to live forever in paradise. So we need to think about then, what am I doing in my life today that shows God that I want to be obedient to Him, that I want to be in a place where I can welcome back my dead loved ones who have fallen asleep? Well, we have to live according to Bible principles, don't we? We have to live according to the way God wants us to live. And if we do that, then we will have a chance to live forever and to be with our ones that we love so much. So comforting to know, just briefly from what we discussed, how precious it is for us to live our lives now in the way that God approves. Make no mistake about it. Yes, this is a hard time for family and for all those who love Mama. We know that. But according to the Bible, she's only asleep in God's memory. And God doesn't forget anything. He knows all things. He has the ability and the capacity to renew everything. And that's what He's going to do. So I encourage you to look into God's Word, the Bible, to see further how you can benefit from some of the things that we've talked about today. And if you do, you're going to be amazed how loving God is. It's not an outdated book that we should just put on the shelf and forget about, or think that it has no meaning. We need to look at God's Word as a book of hope, because that's what it is. It gives hope for those who live in this terrible world that we're living in today. So please, if you have any questions about some of the things that we covered, please, ask Sister Olga, you can ask me, and I'll be happy to share some of these scriptural verses with you so that you too can see what God has promised will come true. So I'd just like to thank all of you for letting me come to be a part of this. I really appreciate Sister Olga even thinking of me and Roy to even come to do this. Again, I know it's painful. God knows that. But you can have confidence in knowing that one day soon, God will give her the chance to live again. And you and I want to be there when that opportunity is granted her. So if it's okay with everyone, Sister Olga, could I say a prayer? Okay, for... And so let's do that now, and then again, if you need anything from this information, we'll supply that to you. So let's say a prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Almighty God, we come to you now and we thank you for giving us this opportunity to approach you in prayer. God, Almighty Jehovah, we know you feel the pain of this family. You understand what they're going through. And Jehovah, it hurts you that they have to go through this. Because as you look down on the earth today, Father, you see so many families who are suffering. You see so many people who are really going through terrible, hard times, whether it's related to the current situation which the world is facing, or maybe there are other things that people are going through. But no matter what it is, dear Father, you understand it and you know it well. So please, bless this family. Help them. Help them to grieve, Jehovah, and understand that grieving is a normal process. And that one day soon, in the very near future, according to Revelation chapter 21, that this, what we're going through right now, will be a thing of the past. So again, please bless this family, bless all the grandkids, the children, the cousins, the nieces, the nephews. Jehovah, they need you right now. They need you, Father. The Bible describes you as a God of comfort, a God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our trials and tribulations. And so, Father, we ask that you be with them at this time. So please help us all to really investigate your word, the Bible, to see all the beautiful promises that you have laid out for us. And we look forward, Jehovah, to that time when, again, no one will grow old, no one will get sick, and no one will die. So again, Father, we thank you for all the many things that you provide. We love you so much, Jehovah. We know this is not your fault. This is not your purpose. This is because of the activities of Satan, the devil, that humans are experiencing these terrible things. But we know, Father, that you're going to reverse it. You're going to correct all the things that he's done, and we look forward to that time. Please, Father, continue to bless us. Help us to think about you and what you want to do in the future. And we pray all of this in Jesus' name.